Did Madeleine Petch break the no spoilers rule on the first episode of the newest season? Why does Lily Reinhardt hate her character's look? And how does KJ Apa plan to keep breaking one of the most important rules? Hi, I'm Janet, and today, The Catcher is revealing the strict rules that every Riverdale actor has to follow if they want to keep their job. 1. Learn your lines. Okay, this may seem like a super obvious rule for actors, but we're not talking about their character's dialogue. Nope. Before every interview that they do, the entire Riverdale cast is given a list of things they can talk about, as well as a list of things they are not allowed to say. And though it's probably really hard for the actors to remember their dialogue and their talking points, it's for a good reason. Nobody wants the cast to accidentally leak the details from the show. Also, you won't be quoted out of context. Like when Lily said she felt like a prisoner because she was stuck in quarantine, and the press made it look like she thought being on Riverdale was like being in prison. Ouch. 2. Be nice or go home. Hold up. There are people who don't know this? We're pretty sure it goes without saying that you should be nice to your coworkers to avoid scandals. But I guess the CW network needs to remind its stars about this. Not only are the Riverdale stars expected to be nice to each other on set, but they're banned from throwing shade off-screen, and especially on social media. And that's just a good rule for life, guys. You're not gonna get far if you're mean and hard to work with. But that doesn't mean there hasn't been any drama on the Riverdale set. Okay, I lied. That's exactly what it means. Although the cast was initially hesitant about their Kiwi leading man, KJ Apa, because they thought he was arrogant, the actor later revealed he was really just incredibly shy and didn't feel as though he fitted in with his American castmates.
I saw KJ's Twitter, and he was smashing 2 Red Bulls and flexing. And I was like, oh God, here we go.
Yeah, I thought KJ was going to be really like into himself. Yeah.
Thankfully, they all talked it out, and now the cast is as close off screen as they are on screen. 3. No spoilers. That's right, CW and Netflix are both really strict about the cast not leaking any spoilers for the show, so the actors don't even get their full scripts until the last minute to avoid them knowing what will happen and possibly sharing that very valuable information. And it gets worse. The cast are also not allowed to have their mobiles on set or take any pictures and videos while working, but they have encrypted emails with specific passwords so that if any hackers access Riverdale details, they'll know who to fire. Yes, it's a fireable offense. Ouch! And though this really isn't a problem for most of the cast because they're all so busy working, it poses a slight problem for Madeleine, who's got to be careful about what she shows on her YouTube vlogs. In fact, in one of her videos, she mentioned the Riverdale prom, a detail that the producers might not want to have revealed. Oops! So that's why we only ever see her Riverdale changing room in her videos. She wants to keep her job, even if it makes her background a little boring.
As you can see by the title of this video, I am heading back to work for season 5 of Riverdale today. I'm really excited to go back to work.
My voice is so... I'm sorry.
At least she's owning it.
Here she is. Today's look, featuring 26-year-old going to prom.
4. Your body is a temple, so keep it healthy. If you've ever wondered how one show can have so many beautiful people in it, it's probably because Netflix and the CW both have high standards for the actors. Apart from no makeup being allowed on set, to give the makeup department a nice fresh canvas to work with, the actors aren't allowed to have tattoos and need to follow exercise regimes and diets to ensure that they stay looking good and in shape with flawless skin. After all, nobody will want to see an actress with a ton of makeup plastered all over her spots and rings under her eyes. But there's more. None of the cast are allowed to cut their hair or change the style. Guys, is there no budget for a few wigs? And several of the teens, notably KJ Apa, have to dye their hair to look more like their character. And having someone else decide your look can be hard. Lily Reinhardt, for one, isn't a huge fan of her character's hair. She even told Allure, "This ponytail causes me stress. It takes a long time to style, longer than you'd think, and it's really annoying and very frustrating." But this is actually the most challenging rule for the man behind Archie. Not only does he have to dye his hair and eyebrows, and let us tell you, that's no fun. He actually told Marie Claire, "It was really painful the first and second time. They ended up bleaching my eyebrows, and I had 2 holes. They burnt into my skin." But he needs to spend about 40 minutes getting his tattoos covered over by the makeup department every time he has had a shirtless scene, which is just about every episode if we're honest. And it probably won't get any better. He's already gotten 2 more tats while he's been working on Riverdale, and will probably get more. In an interview with People, he said, "I'm addicted to them. I love tattoos. I love the art of them. and I love the experience of getting them. And that's not all. He's got to make sure those abs he's always showing off look good. So he's on a strict diet and exercise regimen to stay ripped. Sadly, it means he doesn't get to eat any of the fries when the gang is filmed eating. We really must suffer to be beautiful. 5. You're the only one for me, or else. It may sound romantic to say that Netflix and CW want these actors all to themselves, but it's not really, because Riverdale is shot every day until completion. There's no time for the actors to have a side project, and even if they did, their employers wouldn't be happy about it. In fact, the Riverdale stars are not allowed to have any scheduling conflicts, no other projects or movies on the go, unless they take place only when Riverdale isn't being filmed. But considering that the show is filmed literally every day of the week while shooting, that's just not possible. 6. Life is a song, so sing it. If you thought that the Riverdale cast is really musical, it's not an accident. When the different actors auditioned for their roles, they had to prove they could sing and dance, which is why it's hilarious that some of the cast, especially Cole Sprouse, have hinted that they don't like the musical episodes in the show. And though KJ is actually a talented guitar player, he even released his first album when he was just 14, called The Backroom. But the actor has pointed out that playing the guitar and singing are two different skill sets, and he's definitely less fond of the singing. 7. Respect the brand and each other. While Riverdale features some of the most beautiful young actors in the industry, and we've all seen KJ Apa with his shirt off enough times to know just how hard his six-pack is, the cast is forbidden from posting any pictures of themselves on social media that is revealing or sexy. This may seem a little confusing. They're made to look sexy every day on set, but it's really about maintaining the good image of the show. Too many times we've seen celebs posting pretty raunchy pictures of themselves online, and that's just not the image that the Riverdale team wants its cast to have. These guys need to be classy at all times. And in the same line, the actors are expected not to have relations with other cast members and to always be totally respectful of members of the opposite sex. That means no flirting or lingering hugs. Also, if they do date a co-star and it ends badly, they are still expected to bring their A-game and be absolutely professional with their ex, which must be really challenging. Of course, we understand that these kinds of rules came about after the hashtag MeToo movement, but it's gotta pose some challenges for the actors, especially for Cole and Lily, who have gotten back together after a break. 8. A contract doesn't mean job security. No one likes to say goodbye to their favorite character, and we can only imagine how hard it is when you're an actor who finds out you're being killed off. But all good things must come to an end. Sadly, just having a contract for a number of seasons and episodes doesn't actually mean you'll appear for that period of time. The risk of being killed off can come at any time. When it does, the actor is expected to still stay on for the duration of their contract, in case the show wants to film any additional material or flashback scenes. Luckily, they're still paid for the remainder of a contract, even if they don't get asked back. So it's not all doom and gloom. 9. Your personal safety is important. But not all the rules are in place to protect the show. There's a very important rule in place to keep the actors safe. After an incredibly long day of filming in 2017, KJ Apa was driving home when he fell asleep at the wheel and had a car accident. Although no one was hurt, it served as a warning for the cast that they needed to look after themselves. And they were shaken, with a few of the cast members asking for the studio to make their working environment safer. In response, the show's producers told Business Insider that, in accordance with industry standard policy, if any cast or crew member feels tired or unsafe at any time after working, the studio will provide a taxi, a driver, or a hotel room upon request. So KJ was spot on when he told Esquire, "It was a blessing in disguise. I came out unscathed, and I learned from it. Thank goodness for that." 10. Be ready for anything. As if the threat of being written out of a show or fired for accidentally posting spoilers wasn't bad enough, there's a final rule that makes sure the Riverdale actors are always on their toes, and that's to expect the unexpected. Whether it's the death of a co-star or an international pandemic, they need to make sure they're ready to change their character, location, or story if needed. And as we wait for the 5th season of Riverdale to be released, we're excited to see how the actors have applied this rule. What's next for Archie and his Riverdale friends? We're excited to find out. What do you think will happen in the newest season of Riverdale? Let us know in the comments below. And as always, thanks for watching.